हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू नॉलेज गैलेक्सी टू रीडिस्कवर द बेसिक्स विद मयंक तिवारी, ए प्रीमियर कोचिंग एंड ट्रेनिंग चैनल डेडिकेटेड टू मेटलर्जी स्टडीज एंड कंसल्टेंसी, एस्टेब्लिश्ड टू कैटर द नीड्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स डिग्री डिप्लोमा एंड MIIM मेटलर्जी कॉम्पिटिटिव एंड रिक्रूटमेंट एग्जाम्स फॉर गेट सेल एंड वेरियस अदर गवर्नमेंट एंड प्राइवेट सेक्टर कंपनीज मेटलर्जिकल इंडस्ट्रीज एंड हूसोएवर सीकिंग नॉलेज एंड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स एंड टॉपिक्स ऑफ मेटलर्जी ऑपरेशनल प्रोसेस ऑप्टिमाइजेशन प्रोडक्टिविटी इंप्रूवमेंट एनालिसिस कॉन्सेप्ट्स लाइक 5S टोटल प्रोडक्टिव मेंटेनेंस TPM क्वालिटी सर्कल QC रूट कॉज एनालिसिस RCA ISO systems, QMS, EMS and OSHAs, practical and effective communication English, written and spoken. This is the foundation stone of forming this channel. To impart practical industrial knowledge as per your specific requirements via tailor-made training sessions for your colleagues, employees and students, please contact me on knowledgegalaxy26@gmail.com or WhatsApp me on +91 99071 44101 for scheduling and organizing the sessions at your place or via video conferencing. My dear friends, you might have heard that training is costly, but not to train is still costlier. So do get your employees, colleagues and students trained on the relevant topics so that they perform well on their duty and subsequently contribute positively to the growth of your company and organization in a better way. So do contact me as soon as possible for organizing the sessions and get them trained. Dear friends, another important aspect of Knowledge Galaxy is that specialized subject-wise coaching classes are available for Diploma Engineering, Metallurgy and Mechanical, IIM, Indian Institute of Metals, Part 2 or Section B, and competitive and recruitment exams for GATE, SAIL and various other government and private sector companies. Metallurgical industries, here complete syllabus coverage will be offered for the students aspiring to appear in the forthcoming semester exams, that is December or June. So please contact me on knowledgegalaxy26@gmail.com or WhatsApp me on +91 99071 44101 for scheduling and organizing the classes via video conferencing. My dear friends, now the technology has improved so much that actual physical distance doesn't matter anymore. You can get your doubts clarified and clear all your doubts and gain knowledge by sitting at your home or office or wherever you are comfortable with. So use the technology and get your doubts cleared. Do contact me as soon as possible. My dear friends, I have made so many videos which are available in my channel. I request you all to please visit my channel regularly and repeatedly and do watch all the videos available there. And also request you to watch all the videos from start to finish in complete so that you can gain complete knowledge about the topic or subject, as little knowledge or less knowledge or half knowledge is more dangerous than no knowledge. So it is always better to get the total or complete knowledge about the subject. My dear friends, currently I am covering the syllabus of material science, which is a very important subject of metallurgical and mechanical engineering for students of diploma and degree both. And right now I will be covering about crystal directions and planes and Miller indices in this video. Other topics related with material science subject videos are available on my channel. The link is given in the video. So you do watch all the videos relevant to you and clear all your doubts. So let us start this video, crystal directions and planes and Miller indices. Let us start. Crystal directions. You might be having some questions about what is crystal directions. So let me explain it. To understand the crystal directions, let's first consider the case of two dimensions. The crystal directions is described by writing the integer point x and y in big brackets through which the direction lines passes. In a similar way, the crystal directions in 3D are written as x, y, z, written in parentheses or big brackets, where x, y and z are the first integral points corresponding to the three mutually perpendicular axes x, y and z respectively. I once again repeat this as it is very important. In a similar way, the crystal directions in 3D are written as x, y and z under parentheses, where x, y and z are the first integral points corresponding to the three mutually perpendicular axes x, y and z respectively. Now let us discuss about the law of rational indices. What it is, let us see. This law states that the intercepts of any face of a crystal along the crystallographic axis are either equal to unit intercepts, that is A, B and C, or some simple whole number multiples of them. Once again, I am repeating this as this is very important law of rational indices. This law states that the intercepts of any face of a crystal along the crystallographic axis are either equal to unit intercepts A, B or C, or some simple whole number multiples of them. Let us discuss about crystallographic planes, what they are. The crystal lattice may be regarded as made up of parallel equidistant planes passing through the lattice points, which are known as lattice planes. This definition is also very much asked in Viva Voice and interview questions. So you do remember this and clearly understand the two definitions and law. For a given lattice, the lattice points on lattice planes can be chosen in different ways. These planes are also called crystallographic planes or atomic planes. These planes and crystal directions play an important role in hardness, plastic deformation and other properties. So let us now discuss about Miller indices. Based on the law of rational indices developed by French physicist and mineralogist Abbé Rémy, just how William Heloise Miller evolved and popularized the method of representing crystal planes and directions. In this method, to represent a crystal plane, a set of three integers h, k and l are written within parentheses as h, k, l. Similarly, the crystal directions is represented as a set of three numbers written within the square brackets u, v, w. The Miller indices of a crystal are inversely proportional to the intercepts of that face on the axis. Once again, I am repeating this. The Miller indices of a crystal are inversely proportional to the intercepts of that face on the axis. Miller indices are used to designate the relation of a set of planes to the axis of unit cell. One corner of the system is assumed to be the origin of the space coordinates and any set of plane given by reciprocals of its smallest intersection with these coordinates. The unit of coordinates is taken as the lattice parameters of the crystal. If a plane is parallel to certain axis, the plane intersects that axis at infinity. Do remember this and clearly understand. If a plane is parallel to certain axis, the plane intersects that axis at infinity. These directions and planes could be in lattices or in crystals. It should be mentioned at the outset that special care should be given to see if the indices are in a lattice or in a crystal. Again repeating it, as it is very important and you should not get confused. It should be mentioned at the outset that special care should be given to see if the indices are in a lattice or in a crystal. The number of indices will match with the dimension of the lattice or the crystal. That is, in 1D there will be one index and 2D there will be two indices, etc. Now let us discuss about the method to find the Miller indices of a plane. It is very important to understand it very clearly. So make sure you understand it very clearly. To find out the Miller indices of a given plane, following steps are to be followed. The intercepts made by the plane along the x, y and z axis are noted. The coefficients of the intercepts are noted separately. Now, inverse of these coefficients are taken. The fractions are multiplied by a suitable number so that all the fractions become integers. Write the integers within the parentheses, which is the Miller indices for the plane. The positive x-axis is represented as 100, y-axis as 010 and z-axis as 001. Do remember this. The positive x-axis is represented as 100, y-axis as 010 and z-axis as 001. Similarly, the negative x-axis is represented as (1, 0, 0), y-axis as 0, (1, 0), and z-axis as 0, (0, 1). Let us now discuss about the Miller indices for directions in 2D. How to demonstrate and how to evaluate. As you can see, this is the infinite array of lattice points. So to determine the Miller indices of this particular point, say for example this, let us consider that this is the origin point 0, 0, and we have to determine this 4.3. So and same is this another example. To determine, we can take A is as this and B vector as this. So to determine this particular point's Miller indices, we have to calculate the distances of intersecting points along the axis. So it comes to 5A and 3B. So Miller indices comes, 5 is this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 3 is 1, 2, 3. So wherever they intersect, it becomes the Miller indices for that particular point, and it becomes Miller indices as written as 5, 3. I hope it is very clear to you. Miller indices for directions in 3D. A vector r passing from the origin to a lattice point can be written as r is equal to R1A plus R2B plus R3C, where A, B and C are the basic vectors. So R is equal to, this formula can be written as R1 into vector A plus R2 vector B plus R3 vector C. Basis vectors are unit lattice translation vectors which define the coordinate axis as in the figure below. As you can see, these are the normal vectors, vector A, vector B and vector C, and these are their different angles alpha, beta and gamma. Note, their length is not one unit like for the basis vectors of a coordinate axis. Important directions in 3D represented by Miller indices for cubic lattice. Let us discuss about them. Please memorize these. These are the various directions and important planes, Miller indices for cubic lattice represented in this figure. You can pause this video and get the clarity on this picture, and do remember all the directions and planes. Procedure is as before. Coordinates of the final point is coordinates of the initial points and reduced to smallest integer values. This will be the procedure, and in this way you can find the Miller indices of cubic lattice. This figure shows possible coordinates in 3D. So you can note down all the possible coordinates in 3D, how to represent them, and especially if you have confusion while selecting origin in negative indices, you can refer this figure. So now let us discuss about family of directions. What is that? A set of directions related by symmetry operations of the lattice or the crystal is called a family of directions. Again, I am repeating. A set of directions related by symmetry operations of the lattice or the crystal is called a family of directions. A family of directions is represented in Miller index notation as U, V, W under small brackets. So let us, this table describes about the members in family of cubic lattice. So you can note down all these indexes and the table number also you can note down. So here the point to note is that the negatives opposite directions, this is two negatives, and you can see that in details in table. So to just sum up, this symbol is used for particular direction and this is used for family of directions. This is the alternate symbol. In this slide we will now discuss about Miller indices for planes. Miller indices for planes is not as intuitive as that for directions, and special care must be taken in understanding them. Here in this figure illustrated here for the cubic lattice, you can observe this different directions, unit A, B and C, different vectors, and this is the plane. And now let us discuss how to find the Miller indices for this plane. Find intercepts along the axis 2, 3, 1, axis 2, 3 and 1. So take the reciprocal, that is 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and 1. Now convert to smallest integers in the same ratio. So here multiply all these things with number 6. So that you will get 3, 2 and 6 respectively. Now enclose in parentheses, so it brings 3, 2, 6. So it becomes the Wheeler indices for the plane as 3 to 6. I hope it is clear to you. Now let us discuss about important planes in 3D represented by Miller indices for cubic lattice. So the details are given in this picture. You can note down by pausing the video and clearly observe that different planes, different directions. So you can pause it for different better understanding of the different Miller indices, important planes. Now, a set of planes related by symmetry operations of the lattice or the crystal is called a family of planes. All the points which one should keep in mind while dealing with directions to get the members of a family should also be kept in mind when dealing with planes. So, this is the family of planes. How it is differentiated, how it is measured, how it is distributed and how it is represented, you can note down from all this information from this slide. Different colors have been used to demonstrate different planes. So the purpose of using reciprocal of intercepts and not intercepts themselves in Miller indices becomes clear, the infinity are removed. So you can see this. Both pictures depict different planes. Here you can see the details and it's a different family of planes. Note down the different details mentioned in these figures. So now points about planes and directions. There are some important points which we can and we should always remember. So for unknown direction, we write it them as u, v, w under the big brackets. Second, for unknown planes, we write under a small bracket h, k, l. Double digit indices should be separated by commas like this 1, 2, 2, 2 and 3. And in cubic lattices or crystals, HKL, that is in parenthesis, perpendicular to this HKL, means direction is perpendicular to plane. Interplanar spacing, that is DHKL in cubic lattice and crystals, is given by this formula. D is equal to cubic lattice, DHKL is cubic lattice, is equal to A divided by under root h square plus k square plus l square. So you can very much note down this formula. It is very important. Many times it has been asked in either Viva Voce and other objective type exams. So in this table it shows that which direction is particular direction and which direction is family of directions. So you can note down the details from this. You can observe this table by pausing the video. Let us note, a direction in 3D can be specified by three angles or the three direction cosines. There is one equation connecting the three direction cosines. This is cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. You can note down this equation and do remember always. Again repeating this, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. This implies that we required only two independent parameters to describe a direction. Then why do we need three Miller indices? You might be having this question. So let us now answer this. The Miller indices prescribe the direction as a vector having a particular length, that is This prescription of length requires the additional index. Similarly, three Miller indices are used for a plane like HKL, as this has additional information regarding interplanar spacing. Example, D HKL for cubic lattice is equal to A divided by under root H square plus K square plus L square. Again, this formula has been repeated. So you can see and observe this cubic lattice, different axis and different directions. So now let us discuss about hexagonal crystals, Miller-Bréviat indices for planes. Directions and planes in hexagonal lattices and crystals are designated by the four index Miller-Bréviat notation. In the four index system, the first three indices are a symmetrically related set on the Bessel plane. Second, the third index is a redundant one which can be derived from the first two and is introduced to make sure that members of a family of directions or planes have a set of numbers which are identical. The fourth index represents the c-axis, that is perpendicular to the Bessel plane. Hence, the first three indices in a hexagonal lattice can be permuted to get the different numbers of a family, while the fourth index is kept separate. You can observe this in this picture, how it is done. In this picture, hexagonal crystals, Miller-Bréviat indices for planes is depicted. In general, their three indices point is denoted as Miller indices, that is HKL, again repeating the same thing. But hexagonal crystals, we are using four indices, points is denoted by Miller-Bréviat indices, that is HKIL. The use of the four index notation is to bring out the equivalence between crystallographically equivalent planes and directions. Here there is something different. You might have noticed, like intercepts 1, 1, minus half, infinity, plane is 1, 1, bar 2, 0. So its indices becomes H, K, I and L. What is I? I is equal to minus H plus K. So you can note down this distinction, how it is calculated, how it is described. I hope it is very much clear to you. Now, hexagonal crystals, Miller-Bréviat indices and planes, continuing the same thing. So here intercepts are 1, minus 1, infinity and infinity, and Miller is 1, bar 1, 0. Miller-Bréviat lattice is 1, bar 1, 0, 0. Obviously, the green and blue planes belong to the same family and first three indices have the same set of numbers as brought out by the Miller-Bréviat system. You can very easily observe these things because different color has been used. Like this, for blue, intercepts are infinity, 1, minus 1, infinity, and Miller indices are 0, 1, 0, and Miller-Bréviat index are 0, 1, bar 1, 0. I hope I am making a point and it is very well understood by you all. Again, continuing some other different descriptions for different planes. You can note down, observe these different planes by pausing this video. Some more further examples, how to describe different directions, different planes. in Miller-Breweis indices for hexagonal system. Let us now sum up and discuss about hexagonal crystals Miller-Breweis indices for directions. Drawing the 1, 1, bar 2, 0 direction. How to draw this? Let us discuss. Trace a path along the basis vectors as required by the direction. In the current example, move 1 unit along A1, 1 unit along A2 and minus 2 units along A3. This is described as different vectors. So A1, A2, A3 are described and you have to move like accordingly this way. And directions are projected onto the basis vectors to determine the components, and hence the Miller-Breweis indices can be determined as in the table like this. Shown minus 2 shifted for clarity. You can very well observe this. So now drawing the 1, 0, bar 1, 0 direction. This is how to draw it. Steps are the same. Again, some more information about hexagonal crystals Miller-Breweis indices for directions. Transformation between 3 index u, v, w and 4 index small u, v, t, w notations. How it is transformed in these two? Capital U is equal to small u minus t. Capital V is equal to small v minus t. And w is equal to small w. Other formulas are given here. You can pause the video and note down all the formulas and observe them very clearly. And it is very well represented in this diagram. Which direction, how to determine, how to take the directions, how to take the negatives. So you can pause the video and observe this very carefully. Directions in the hexagonal system can be expressed in many ways. Three indices by the three vector components along A1, A2 and C, and R U V W is equal to U A1 plus V A2 plus W C. In the three index notation, equivalent directions may not seem equivalent, while in the four index notations, the equivalence is brought out. This is the main important point which is described in this figure and all these formulae. So let us now sum up about the directions and planes. Which direction is perpendicular to which planes? For cubic systems, the HKL direction is perpendicular to plane HKL. For tetragonal system, only special planes are perpendicular to the direction with same indices, like 100 direction is perpendicular to 100 plane, 010 direction is perpendicular to 010 plane, and 001 direction is perpendicular to 001 plane, 110 direction is perpendicular to 110 plane, and 101 direction is not perpendicular to 101 plane. Again, this is their difference, so do remember this. 101 direction is not perpendicular to 101 plane. For orthorhombic system, 100 direction is perpendicular to 100 plane. 010 direction is perpendicular to 010 plane. And 001 direction is perpendicular to 001 plane. For hexagonal systems, 0001 direction is perpendicular to 0001 plane. This is for a general C by A ratio. For a hexagonal crystal with the special C by ratio is equal to under root 3 by 2, the cubic rule is followed. This is the special instruction given here. Let us now discuss about the monoclinic system. 010 direction is perpendicular to 010 plane, And other than these, a general HKL direction is not perpendicular to HKL. I hope this table summarizes all the directions perpendicular to planes and it is clear to you, all of you. My dear friends, hope you liked the content and found the video worth. So please don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. My dear friends, I am making so much effort to provide all the informations which is available to you free of cost. So you just have to visit my channel repeatedly and regularly and follow and subscribe my channel and also watch all the videos available there completely from start to finish so that you can gain the maximum knowledge which is being shared to you all. So my dear friends, also remember to press the bell icon so that you can get the notification of the new videos promptly. So with this, I raised my voice for this video and I hope. Thank you very much for viewing my channel, this video. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Have a nice day. Enjoy your day. Thank you very much. Thank you again.